Hey there everybody, I have an unboxing to do today. This just arrived from the post office. Let's get it cut open and see exactly what is in there. Okay, it looks like I got my receipt. Got a nice DLT trading, kind of like vinyl sticker there. Okay, let's see. Okay, there it is. Oh, look at that. LT Wright Knives. This is my very first LT knife. Never had one before. This one here is the Jessmuk-C. It's in AEB-L Stainless Steel. It's got a scandi-grind and black polished micarta. So let's get that open. Okay, there that is. There is the sheath. This was really hard, like, to judge just from watching on YouTube how small or how large this sheath and knife was going to be, but it's actually a little smaller than what I had imagined. This is a JRE sheath that they make for LT Wright knives. This is my second JRE sheath. I actually bought one, I believe it was years ago, for a for my K-bar BK2. Here's the knife. Okay, nice packaging. Wow, that is a small blade. You ready, everyone? Big reveal. Ooh, look at that. This thing's got some weight considering how small it is. I have large to extra large hands. Just shy of extra large, and it fits me fine. I even got a little space there. It's got the scalloped handles, so you can pinch up on it on either one side or the other, whether you're right or left hand. Or you can just do a double pinch like that for fine detail work. This is a fat eighth of an inch, at least I can tell just by looking at it. And this is the AEB-L Stainless Steel. And it supposedly, like all LT Wright knives, has an excellent heat treat on it. It has their little cabin symbol and then the letter L. I don't know if that's showing up at all. Right there. Okay, this has the Prepared Mind 101 symbol that he uses on YouTube. Chris Tanner designed this knife, and the original one was the Jessmuk JX2, and it has a larger blade and a larger handle. But and it's made out of 01 tool steel, or you can also get it in CPM 3V. This one here, like I said, is the stainless steel version. It's the little companion. It only has two pins instead of three, like its larger brother. But it does have a brass lanyard hole there, brass line. You can see it's full tang. Black canvas micarta. Looks great. Feels really good in the hand too. Looks nice and straight. It's got a pretty stout tip on it. So I think you could do like bow drill divots with this pretty easily. And it has the drop point blade there. It has an ulu design, which means that this belly, instead of being forward, is kind of dead center with the blade. And it actually sticks down a little farther than the finger guard, which gives you that great slicing ability. It does have a nice finger guard on it. It's got a little swell there for your palm. It does somewhat resemble a Jessmuk style knife, but it is different. Like, it doesn't have the upsweep bulge right here. It just comes kind of straight and drops. And then this is very centered, the bend. That ulu curve there, the belly. And then it also has a scandi edge on it, a true scandi grind. So it should be great for feather sticks and small wood processing. You could probably use it also for skinning and food prep and anything like that. LT Wright knives come with a, wow, that is sharp. It's just grabbing my skin, a very sharp 90 degree spine. So you can strike a Ferro rod with that without any issue. It's kind of like the Mora Bushcraft Black in the handle, but it is different, being that it's micarta. But it fills the hand pretty good. Like, it's small, but it's a nice little knife, from what I can tell just by how it feels to grip it. Very easy. You could just keep your thumb up there on it too, choke up on that. Yeah. That's pretty neat. But this is the leather sheath that it comes with. Got a sheet of printer paper here. We'll see if it arrives sharp. Haven't even wiped this off or anything. This is just straight out of the box. Well, let's see. Oh, wow. Jeez. Yeah, that's probably gonna cut me at some point. That is freaking stupid sharp. Oh god, it almost just falls through the paper. Look at that. Oh jeez, almost got myself already. That is sharp, wow. Goodness, you could literally shave with this. All right, next we're gonna get a little bit of a size comparison. Here's a quarter. You can see that is far from a huge knife, even though it does have some weight to it. It is, oh, mine here is about 7 3/4 to the tip. The handle is 4 5/8 to the very edge there. So, yep. And the cutting edge is, looks like 3.5, right on the dot. Thickness of the handle is under an inch, probably about 7/8. And the width of the blade is, from the fattest point there, you're looking at 1 1/4. Yep, right there, 1 1/4. Yeah, I'm actually surprised at the amount of weight this tiny little knife has. And let's see, as far as the thickness, I'm guessing a full eighth. Yep, that's right on the money. A full eighth of an inch. All right. LT Wright is known for their heat treat. It's said that they have probably the best heat treat in the business for like production knives. And I've never purchased one before, and I don't know why. I just always ended up going with like something else, or going with like Bark River, which I do love. But yeah, this, and I'm actually really liking this knife. It's got a little leather sheath, which does have a nice welt in it. It's got the ferro rod stitched right in. You can wear it directly on your belt, or you can, and take this off, or you can wear it with the dangler. That's probably what I would do. But let's put this in there. Yeah, I'm a little worried about pushing this in because this thing is so sharp. I bet you it could just cut through that like a hot knife through butter. Yeah, look at that. What a nice fit. Now I gotta get a ferro rod for this. It looks like it's either 5/16. I think it might be a little bigger. It could be the 3/8. 5/16 might be perfect though. But yeah, it's a small little sheath. Like if you hide the dangler, you see like the whole package there is not that huge. But yeah. This kind of, like, this system here and the dangler kind of reminds me of my, what's it called? It's the Benchmade Bushcrafter that I have. And I bought the dangler separate, but it's basically, like, almost this exact setup. Just a lighter kind of a suede sheath, but size-wise, very similar. And I really like that knife. It's pretty nice, but yeah, this one, it's unique. I'm really liking that ulu shape. And that freaking super 90 degree spine. And a really nice handle. I don't know what it is about black canvas micarta. It's definitely one of my favorite handle scale material. But let's see here. I think I covered everything about it. As far as all I know about the AEB-L stainless steel, is it supposed to be corrosion resistant? And if it has a great heat treat from LT Wright, which it probably does, it should hold an edge quite well. And it's known to be a tough steel, like a real quality steel. So yeah, my first LT Wright knife. Finally got one after all these years. And like I said before, this is a Chris Tanner design. He is the guy from Prepared Mind 101 on YouTube. And he's got some pretty wild knife designs and some pretty wild knife handle designs. But I gotta say, lately the Jessmuk JX2 and this Jessmuk-C have really caught my attention. And yeah, I can't wait to take this out and use it. I might even take this to work, kind of use it as my like everyday carry knife. But now I'm on a quest to find a Jessmuk JX2 with the black micarta handle. I like the O1 steel, and the CPM3V is fine too. I'd take either one. But I got my eyes peeled for that because I'd like to add it to my collection. And I don't know if another run of them is going to come around again. They're sold out pretty much everywhere I look. So I'm hoping like a DLT trading or knives ship free or someone like that gets another batch of the JX2s in so that I can hopefully snag one or two of them. But here, let's do a size comparison here. This is my off-grid knives Alpha Dog in Cryo D2 steel. This is a stout knife. It's just a hair thicker than this one. Oh, you got me. But yeah, I'm glad I picked this up. I was always kind of holding off a little bit because of it being stainless steel, but mostly because of how small it was. And I'm not a big super fan of these ultra small bushcraft knives, but I do like this design a lot. So I decided to pick one up and yeah. But there it is. That's all I have for this video.
This is Joe Doomsday, signing out.